Okay, hello everyone and welcome back, SoupaSoka, and today we're playing Atom Zombie Smasher. It's a crazy name, and it's a pretty crazy game actually. Came out in 2011 by Blendo Games, a small indie studio. They released maybe 4 or 5 games. I think they have another one in the works. A very small studio. So it came out in 2011, and it's kind of a real-time strategy game. It was also released in the third Humble Indie Bundle, so that's actually how I obtained the game from the Humble Indie Bundles. I probably bought the first like 5 or 6 Humble Indie Bundles, and probably didn't play them as much as I should have, so that's why we're going through a lot of these now. But Atom Zombie Smasher is a really cool game. It's actually one of my favorite games. So we're going to start a new campaign today. We're going to do normal victory point limit, and we're not going to set any modifiers. We're just going to leave it all alone. But these are things you can do to customize your experience, and it gives you a lot more replayability. It's actually very cool, but we're just going to start it normal. And we're going to see how this all goes. Okay, kind of a cool intro. So in each stage of the game, you get a custom event that occurs. Most of the time they're good, sometimes they're bad. For example, in this one, we're going to get increased helicopter speed, and we'll explain what that means in a little bit. So we can only evacuate this one city at a time, pretty much. Whichever city has a little number, so we're going to start with this one. We select this territory to evacuate. And you can see the bottom that the difficulty is 1, the reward is more mercenaries, and the population is 125. And this little welcome thing over here we can read. These little tips are pretty handy, but we're not going to go too far into reading all of these. There's quite a lot there, and it's just too much to read it all. But let's get started. Okay, so if they click the evac helicopter button, so we're going to click that. It says it's an air unit, transport civilians to safety. Helicopters will gather civilians within a specified radius. Right-click to reposition the landing zone. Okay, place the landing zone away from the Zed. So the Zed, the zombies basically, they'll spawn from these three streets, and they're going to pretty much flood in this direction. And we can also see our civilians are represented by these yellow dots. We're going to zoom in a bit. You can see these yellow dots. Those are civilians. And anything that's around these white circles, kind of around our helicopter, you can see the radius, the full diameter there. Anything that falls in that circle will be kind of signaled to run to the helicopter. So I usually try and put it in a position that's going to attract the most people, I think. So let's just toss it there. See what happens. Our mission for this one is to collect at least 10 civilians, and I think, let's see if I remember this right. There is a way to speed up the game, but I can't remember how to do that. Menu options. No. I don't see controls anywhere. That's okay, we're just gonna let it go. And it looks like we're collecting quite a few of these guys right now. We've got a 17. We only need 10 to win this mission. You can see the zombies are flooding in. They're represented by the pink dots. And as they touch these yellow dots, those also become zombies. So that's no good for us. We're going to redirect our helicopter to a new spot a little bit farther away from the zombies. So it'll pull people in this direction. Give a little more time to load everyone in. Also, these streets obviously you can walk through. This green space, this is like a park area. You can walk through it no problem. But these large blocks are cities, basically, or buildings, and those are impassable. Once you get 30, that's pretty much a full load. We're going to reposition the helicopter over here, because I don't think we're going to be able to rescue these guys. Possibly we can save them if we get in this spot here. They do run away, you can see that pretty clearly, so hopefully these guys will run this way. Looks like they're going to, that's great. You can see the current population is it goes down as we rescue people, and also it goes down as zombies eat people. So that's unfortunate. But we did succeed with this mission. Our rescue goal was 10. We obtained 67. We have a 1x difficulty multiplier, so the points don't matter really. We lost 58 civilians to zombie bites, and you can see if we level up to every time you collect more civilians, you will get skill ups in your helicopter, and it'll basically move faster, hold more people, those types of things. So we need 125 total. We got 67 that time. So let's continue. And this is the victory track. If we fill this up all the way, we win the entire campaign. If they fill this up all the way first, then we lose the campaign. Basically, the first one to score 6,000 rescues or 6,000 infections wins or loses. And along the way, you get these little dots. These are kind of check marks, and if you collect these, you get bonuses. You get more things to help us in the zombie apocalypse to help fight them. Whereas, if the zombies get here, then they get kind of scarier things that are making things a little bit tougher for us. So we're going to continue. Okay, we got a reward as a mercenary. I have to add this mercenary to my roster. I have to sign my name. Click, signed. Kind of a cool design for things here. Just a little bit of aesthetic fun. Left click to continue. Let's see. So shorter daytime in this one. This is a little bit tougher. So this is actually a negative thing for us. The day and night cycle didn't occur in the last stage, but when it goes to nighttime, then zombies will flood in from all sides rather than just the three sides that we saw. So shorter daytimes are worse for us. If you hear some snoring in the background, by the way, we're babysitting our friend's pug right now, and that pug happens to be sitting on my lap, and he snores, because pugs have apnea, I think. So, not sleep apnea, they have life apnea. Okay, so we're going to set up... let's set up this location. There is some strategy to this, in that... I'll show you later how this matters. We're going to pick this kind of more open spot, rather than the one directly where we just rescued. So now we have snipers this time. So rooftop sharpshooters. Snipers will shoot at the Zed closest to their aim spot. During the action phase, right-click to reposition aim spot. So the action phase is when the actual game is playing. Right now we're in the kind of planning phase, I guess what it says at the top. So if we place a sniper team here, and then we aim them like this, then everything in the highlighted space is in range of them, and they will kill those zombies a little bit by little bit. So I think what we want to do, maybe it's not the best spot. Let's put them, and they'll shoot the ones closest. So what I want to do is position them like this, so that way we will catch these zombies as they're coming through here. Is that right? Yeah, and then, because I want to position my helicopter back here somewhere, so these will take out this top row of Zed as much as possible. And I think we're going to start with our helicopter in the center, and then we're slowly back it up. I think that's what we want to do. There goes the pug snoring away. We're going to see how this plays out. I was trying to remember the... There we go. Figured out the command to speed up the game. It's the plus and minus keys in the keyboard. You can see the snipers are doing a decent job of keeping zombies at bay, but they will eventually flood over the sniper. Snipers can't keep up with these all the way. We're going to reposition this guy back here this time. And we're going to realign their aiming a little bit here. And hopefully this helicopter calls these guys quickly. It looks like it did. So this should work out decently for us, although because it's a shorter daytime, we're going to have a lot of problems soon, I think. Ooh, I made a mistake there. I moved the helicopter too far away, and a lot of people didn't get... The helicopter only stays for a certain amount of time, and we lost a lot of people, unfortunately, because the helicopter left before they all got there. So that was a little bit of a mistake on my part, but it worked out. And the snipers gained 35 skill points because they got 35 kills, so they also need to get 125 to level up. So now we're neck and neck with the zombies here, but eventually some missions you'll be able to blow them out of the water, and that's what we're going to have to hope for. Okay. Looks like we got... So we get some bonus points, by the way, for territory, for home base we get some. And if you full clear an area, like without losing anyone, I think you get bonus points. There's lots of ways to get bonus points, which are really helpful. Slower Zed movements. This is a good one for us. The zombies will move a little bit slower. And this time... Let's grab this centralized one again, and let's see what do we have as our artillery this time. So the artillery you get, the not artillery, but sort of the items you get to help you in the game will rotate a little bit throughout each stage. So it varies from bit to bit. So in this case, we definitely want to be fairly, maybe down here seems okay. I want to try and attract as many of these guys as possible. This seems okay. And then we'll have our sniper set up to hopefully focus on this side here, clear that out. And we've also got this zombie bait, which basically will stall zombies. They'll be attracted to the bait. And I think we get to reuse this, but I don't quite remember it now. Okay, we're not going to place it right now. We can place it during the game, so we're going to definitely be doing that. What we'll probably do is use it to attract zombies back this way to slow them down a little bit. So if these guys start moving down in this direction, we'll put some bait like here. which will pull them all in that direction, which should be helpful for us. Let's reposition this here, and let's set this to re-aim here, and hopefully snipe away a few of these zombies if we can. We're gonna call the group to the left, and that should rescue quite a lot of those people at least, while our little snipers are still doing their thing. We're gonna reset a zombie bait somewhere around here in just a moment, and we're gonna reset our snipers to kind of clear this street as best as possible. And we got our zombie bait pulling people, more people this way at least. This last little guy is probably not gonna make it. A little too slow, but we're gonna see if we can protect him long enough. I don't know if he's gonna make it. Depends how fast the helicopter goes. This guy's all by himself. He's going the wrong way. He's super dead. Sorry, little guy. But we definitely cleared that level easily, and we also upgraded our helicopter. So we now have an upgrade available. And there's either, you can do a couple things with each of these. So like the snipers, you can upgrade, making them relocate their aiming more quickly or increase their fire rate, things like that. In this case, we can choose to either lower the arrival time. So instead of taking 6 seconds to leave and come back, I'll take 5.6. Or we can lower the load time, so load faster. I usually like changing the arrival time, but that's just me. And we managed to get a silver medal for that one. It's a little bit better than last time. And we made a little more headway against them here, which is nice. And what you'll notice is at the end of each stage, we get plus 20 here, and I think they get plus 10 for these, right? Yeah, 10 for each level 1. They'll go to level 2, 3, and 4. Eventually, we'll see how that occurs. When they have like a 2, they get 20 points, a 3, they get 30 points, and a 4, they get 40 points. So it's pretty gross how quickly they can rack up points if we don't clear out some of their higher level ones. Slower Zed movement. Okay. This is a new vignette, so let's take a look. Yeah, I don't really know the backstory of this game very well, to be honest. I never really watched all these vignettes. As much as I enjoy this game, as much as it's one of my favorite games, I pretty much just enjoy the gameplay. Okay, so we got slower Zed movement. It's really good for us. Let's go ahead and grab this one here. So what happens is So you saw that the single points kind of appeared at random locations, right? Sometimes they can land on the same spot. So like this one could have landed on this one and made it a 2. And a 2 is harder to complete than a 1. And a level 3 stage is harder to complete than a 2 and a 1, and a 4 is a very hard stage to complete. But what happens is if you get to a 4, that 4 automatically creates level 1 stages all the way around it. And if that level 1 stage that it creates makes another 3 go to a 4, then that one will spread to more 1s. So you kind of want to clear side-by-side stages as best as possible. If they're next to each other or they're centralized, like this one is kind of touching like 3 other ones, we want to clear this one to reduce the chance that this one will become a 4 later and then buff up all the ones nearby. So this seems like a pretty good one to wipe out. Possibly this one even more so because it's around by 4 plus this one, so maybe this is even better. Just go ahead and clear this one. Okay, so this time we have our helicopter again. We have 3 starting areas. Snipers, the kind of attracting Zed bait, and then this siege bombardment. We can fire one shell before reloading. During action phase, right select artillery and right click to designate targets. This is going to be really cool with this Zed bait. We put the bait, it'll attract a lot of them to one spot, and then we launch the artillery to blow them up. Pretty cool. So what I think I want to do is set our snipers along this center street, try and clear out this designated path. And then what we're going to do is set a bait between these two locations and try and artillery bomb them. If I can time it right, it should work out pretty well. So we'll put this here. And danger close. Right, so we need to put this somewhere maybe over here. We have to actually still place it. If you don't place it, or if you place it like in this, you see the radius around it. Anything that's that close is also kind of in danger of blowing up, but we'll see that in game a little bit more. Oh, the pug on my lap is falling over slowly, sliding off me. Alright, we'll see how this works out. Okay, so we're gonna Zed bait. in a moment. Okay, let's go ahead and fire now. Hopefully this will work well. My timing, it's been a while since I played this, and my timing might not be perfect. A little off, but pretty good, right? Pretty good. Now let's see if we can snipe these last few, and then we'll just clear the whole level. That'd be amazing. So if you just clear a stage, we kill all the zombies before nighttime, then you just win, and everyone's saved. Like that. Like, we just won the entire level. They didn't get a single infection. And that was awesome. So we got a gold medal. Really good for us. Okay, so we got another upgrade for helicopters. It counts all the survivors as being rescued by the helicopter, even though they weren't actually rescued by it. So we're going to speed up the arrival time again. And we're going to continue. So that was good. Real good. So we got a big boost there. They didn't get anything. Territory captured. Because you destroyed all Zed before nightfall, you've captured this territory. Captured territories give you 20 victory points every month. So that's even better. So we're going to go ahead and sign this little thing here. We got some dynamite, which is pretty fun. Dynamite's nice. And now we get 20 points from each of these territories each month. So that's great. So that's a really good boost for us. We're actually outpacing them at the moment. Longer daytime, more Zed. So this one's okay. It means there's more zombies, but we also have more time before nightfall. So that's pretty useful. Okay, we got a bunch of individual ones here again. As usual, I try and find the ones surrounding the most other areas or adjacent to other Zed territories. So let's maybe go for this one. You'll see now, over here, by the way, we've gotten four things. We always have the helicopter. You always get that. But then the other ones, you usually have about two or three, and they'll rotate around. So this time we don't have the bait anymore, unfortunately. Instead, we have dynamite, which is not too bad. So, there's only two entryways for the Zed on this one, which is pretty nice. The dynamite, the way it works, control demolition. Charges are placed during planning phase. During action phase, click this button to detonate all charges. So we only get a single use of the dynamite. We click it and then it blows up and that's the end of it. So what I usually try to do is, for example, let's maybe set up... I usually put in the snipers where there's a more narrow path. Like, either of these are pretty much similar, so it doesn't really matter where we line them up. Let's maybe set them here, however. Okay. Then we're going to put our artillery maybe way down here. We're going to get it... So like, you'll notice when you put this as danger close. If anything gets too close to that, it's a chance you'll blow up that stuff. So basically, you don't want to risk blowing up your artillery. If I put dynamite right here, it could blow up this artillery, and then we can't use it anymore. So that's bad. And what I normally like to do is set up dynamite like this, so it's spaced out a little. Wait till all the Zed flood through, and then just click the button and blow up. Pretty much every single Zed in this area will detonate, which is pretty nice. So, where's our helicopter at? Let's set our helicopter here. Should be okay. And done. So we're going to start by firing here. And then we're going to detonate this once these zombies start moving out a little bit farther. Now. Okay. Pretty good. Let's set a bomb there or set an artillery there. Might be a little bit off target, but I think it'll get a couple at least. It doesn't always land perfectly. That was actually a really good one. That worked out really well for us. So we're sniping these guys pretty well. We've got 42 seconds till daytime ends. Let's aim that there. Let's hopefully we can get these last four here, and then we'll actually win this. Oh, nice. That was a great artillery shot. So that was perfect. We cleared that very easily. And we actually leveled up our snipers now. So this is cool. So now the refire time is we can drop it down by 0.2 seconds. Or the reposition time we can drop to 2 seconds or 3 seconds. I actually like the refire time more. Repositioning is nice, but in general I try to just have them positioned well at the start. So I only have to reposition them maybe once throughout the battle. So the repositioning doesn't come in as handy. Whereas, obviously they're constantly firing, so that's nice to speed that up. So we got almost enough for this next level here. If we get this next one, we get a super scientist or whatever, and it's kind of cool. We get a little more specialization. Shorter daytime. This is straight up just bad for us. Straight negative. Okay. This one's adjacent to this. These are adjacent. Maybe this one is what we want to clear next. We don't have snipers this time or artillery. This is a really bad one for us. In fact, this one's awful. All we can do is barricades, dynamite, and bait. We literally have only one way to kill things with dynamite, so this is an awful, awful arrangement. Sometimes you just get bad luck. Some bad RNG, I guess. So the barricades are nice. They're a fortified obstacle. It diverts foot traffic. Okay. So, like, for, we can't completely block a Zed in. We can't not let them pass, but we can limit their path quite a bit. So, what I basically am thinking of doing... how do we want to do this? Maybe putting a blockade. We only have two blockades. One here. And one here. And this basically means all these zombies, the only way for them to get through is go all the way down here and up this path. And then back up this way. So their choke point is here. They can't get past this. And if we do a good job with baiting and dynamiting, we might be able to clear quite a few of them out. So let's... I don't want to blow up this building here. How do we want to do this? I'm not sure if I'm blowing this up. Actually, let's do this. Hold on a sec. Let's move that there. We're going to have to sacrifice those a few more of those people. I could put it there, 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 there. Hopefully this works. And then we need our helicopter here. We're going to hopefully call as many of these people around as we can. This might blow up in our face. We're going to see what happens. And then we're going to put our bait over here to try and call some of these back to slow them down a bit. And hopefully we'll call them back. Okay, so we're calling these back this way. We're trying to clump more of them here. So that way it buys a little more time so they can stack a little more aggressively onto the dynamite. We're hoping to get as many of them onto the dynamite as possible. We're going to move this a little bit farther away this direction, actually. Ooh, that's a really short daytime. Although this is a good spot for us to be, right here. Because quite a few... There's no zombies spawning on this side, so it's a pretty good spot. Okay, we see a lot of zombies are coming through here soon. We're going to move this a little more that way next time. And we're going to put a Zed bait here and call as many zombies into this area as possible. And we're just going to nuke the crap out of them in a moment. Yeah, it's looking like time to nuke them. Okay, we got a lot of them. Which is good, because that means we should be able to skill up our dynamite a little bit better. And that might pretty much be the end there. And also, if the zombies get to the helicopter, it doesn't matter. Nothing bad happens. The helicopter will just fly away at the last moment. That was a tough one. It's a short daytime and no really good weapons. Really difficult, but we upgraded a lot of stuff. So, the blockades, I don't really know how blockades... upgrade? I think it's by every zombie that turns away from them, possibly. I'm not really sure. Dynamite upgrades by kills. Zed bait, I think, upgrades per zombie attracted. So we've got a lot of upgrades to do here. Let's speed up the arrival time. Let's increase the duration of... What do we want to do? Yeah, let's increase the duration of this by 2 seconds of the... Of the bait. We're going to add another dynamite, which is great. It's a simple one. We just add one more dynamite. And we're going to get a third barricade. So that's really nice. So at least now all of our stuff's a little bit better. We should also maybe hit this. Nice. So super scientists have been spotted. Rescue them to unlock exotic and dangerous technologies. This is where you get, I believe, a little bit of customization in your leveling up. You can choose to upgrade certain things in certain ways, which is nice. Our new weapon is landmines. Landmines are fine. They are basically like dynamite. They only work once, but as soon as something walks onto it, it blows up. So it's nothing we control, just as soon as something lands on it. Increase helicopter speed. That's a nice one. So helicopters are going to move a little bit quicker. Good stuff. Okay, prepare to drop some science research labs available. Click on the research lab button to develop upgrades. Earn upgrades by rescuing scientists. Okay. This is a fairly centralized one here, and it's touching 4 other zones and these two, so we definitely want to clear this one out if we can. And this time we have artillery, snipers, and landmines. This is a pretty solid setup here. Not perfect, but it's pretty good. There's our scientists. We just want to rescue these. There's, we need to rescue 60 civilians in this one, which is not too many. And we should try to rescue a scientist if we can. We don't have to rescue a scientist. Nothing bad happens if you fail. I think I'm going to put the helicopter back here. It's all pulling quite a big crowd there. I'm going to put our artillery way back here. We're going to set our sniper up to... focus down this central one, I think. Is that what we want to do? Yeah, and then... Oh, maybe not. We're going to put landmines here. Oh, let's not do that. I usually try to get the landmine so they're complete. The complete radius at least will be in effect, or the complete diameter will be in effect. If you put them too close to start, then you're wasting like half this bottom half of the circle, right? This bottom half here won't actually do anything, so we don't want to do that if we can help it. And I think the sniper setup here is okay. I'm not sure if it's an ideal situation for this one. I'm also thinking of centralizing this a little more to try and pull in more civilians. If we put it up here, we're only going to get this part here. If we put it here, we'll get a few more civilians attracted, I think. Maybe here. Okay, we're going to see how this works out. Okay, landmines are going to do their thing at the moment. We're going to shoot here. Maybe clear a few of these guys out. They're going to kind of go this direction, so hopefully we'll actually... Uh-oh. A couple of them are going that way. That's not good. Sniper is doing their job. Snipers are doing their job pretty well. However, we need to reposition, and I think we just need to set a nuke there, which maybe is unnecessary. Hopefully this gets cleared up soon. Uh-oh, this is bad. Come on, get that one. Get him. Okay, good. I'm gonna snipe this one. Let's throw a bomb there. We might be able to clear this level if we go fast, but we gotta go real quick to clear these last three. Come on, snipers, get them. One, two, three. Ooh, okay, it's almost nighttime. That was real close. That worked out well. We had 8 infections, but we did get the scientist, and we cleared the full cleared level, which is really important. Hopefully, they're gonna get close to getting this boost soon. We captured the territory. Good stuff. Okay. What did we get? Yes, those are really fun. Infantry are awesome. I love infantry. I think they're really cool. Okay, so, they did hit their 500 as they needed. So, here comes the storm. Containment protocols have suffered catastrophic failure. Expect larger Zed outbreaks. So now we're going to see, instead of ones popping up, we're going to see twos popping up, I think. Or the ones will pop up onto themselves now. Longer daytime. It's a good one for us. Okay, so there goes a bunch of twos. This is what I was saying, where these are a little bit more dangerous. They're more difficult to reward more victory points. These are a little bit easier and don't reward as many. There goes the pug snoring, if you guys heard that. Let's go for this 2, since it's touching a 1 and also this open space here. We're going to go for it. We have snipers, dynamite, infantry. So, normally, whatever your roster is, you can pick a level according to that. So if you get, like, bait, barricades, and landmines, which are pretty bad, you might want to go for an easy one. But we have infantry, dynamite, snipers. That's pretty good. So we should go for a little bit of tougher difficulty. Now what this means is that we basically get more of these things in here, right? So we have the infantry, more of the spawn points. This is a mobile squadron, fires the closest Zed. Okay, you can see anything that is covered up by their space here will be basically hunted down and killed. That's awesome. I think what we're going to try and do is take out this side as best we can, and use the dynamite to stall up here a little and have the snipers positioned to try and fend off this edge also. So I think we're gonna put the helicopter maybe around here somewhere. There's more scientists you might notice in this one. We're gonna put the helicopter here. We're gonna put the infantry maybe here is good. We're gonna locate the sniper, I think. Maybe it's better to put it here. And they will take care of this as best as possible. We're gonna put one dynamite, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we're gonna just blow up these pretty early on, I think. We're just gonna use that to try and hold things off a little bit. And the infantry, we can move them around. You can see they're sniping the crap out of this stuff here, so they're doing a good job. And we're gonna get ready to launch our dynamite now, pretty much. Just took out quite a few things. We're gonna move the infantry down this direction. We're gonna move our helicopter back a little bit next time it lands. I like to move our infantry around as best as possible to kind of keep it mobile and keep it in between our helicopter landing point and the Zed, although it looks like we botched this somehow. We gotta get this down here. Oh, it's bad. That's real bad. Yeah. That's bad. The infantry can't be zombified, by the way. So that's good. But it seems like, I don't know where this group came from, but they moved in really fast and just destroyed us, so that was really bad for us. We barely got the minimum. We got 65 out of 60. That was not a good one. I wasn't really paying attention. I didn't really see where those zombies came from, but there was a lot of infections. So they made a bunch of ground there on us. We were so close to getting our space hammer too. That's too bad. We might get it from our bonus 80 points here. I don't know if we will. Let's see. Is that enough? I think 1200's enough, right? Nice. So God fights in the side with the best artillery. Zed doesn't have the catbird cannon. We do. Rescue civilians and kill Zed to power the super weapon. Catbird cannon's really fun. We'll see what that does soon. You can see the zombie outbreaks are getting more and more out of hand, which is not good. Shorter daytime, less Zed. That's okay. Uh-oh. See, that's what I'm saying. There's a four, and it's spread all over the place. To clear the city, destroy all Zed before nightfall. That's a really tough one. We have infantry, barricade, and Zed. So all we have to kill stuff is infantry, so that's really not going to work for us. So I think we will go for a easier number one here. We'll see if this works. What we want to do is barricade so that everything funnels into the center here. Put our infantry right here. And we'll have to get our Zed bait ready. And we can set this here as fine. And we'll Zed bait. Yeah, so rescue civilians and other things. Then we get the catbird cannon. So orbital kinetic bombardment. Rescue civilians and kill Zed to power this weapon. Weapon is ready, select it, and right click in order to place to use a bombardment. Yep. Pretty simple. We're gonna bait everything towards the infantry, and hopefully the infantry can snipe these things fast enough. I don't know if they're gonna kill it quickly enough, but hopefully they can. 6 seconds, 5 seconds. Are they gonna be able to finish? I don't think so. They're gonna be just a little too slow. It's a little bummer. So close to being able to... Oh, nice, we did do it. Okay, they gave us a little boost there. That was great. So that worked out well. We were able to clear it, which is really nice. What I was hoping for is we'd be able to clear it. We did have two infections. It's not so bad. We still captured the territory, which is a good boost, because every captured territory is 20 more points for us. That's important. And also, that broke up the chain there, so if anything spawned in the middle, it wouldn't spread all over to all these other nearby ones. So that's a good one. Once you capture a territory, it's captured forever, or once you clear it, it's cleared forever. So the black space or the light yellow space is ours permanently. Reduced helicopter speed this time. That's bad. Ooh. Ooh. Ugh. So that was good. See right there, we blocked that. By clearing that, this one didn't spread into that, so that's important for us. We do have some research lab items now. We have 15 scientists collected. So reduced practice improves XP earn rate of all mercenary teams to 110%. Add two extra barrels to artillery cannons, fire multiple shells at one time. And improve scientist movement speed. That's not so useful. This one I like a lot. But also, upgrading the catbird cannon unlock rate's nice. Let's see. Let's go for the improved art. Let's save it. We're gonna upgrade the catbird cannon later. We have artillery, landmines, and snipers. It's a solid one, so let's go for a 2. Do we have a 2 anywhere? This one doesn't really matter. It's already surrounded by other much stuff. This one would be a good one to maybe clear out if possible. Okay, so there's 3 coming in here, 3 coming in here. What we wanted to maybe do this is going to be a tough mission, I think, overall. We're going to aim down this way. We're going to set up our artillery over here. We're going to set our helicopter up here. Maybe here. We're going to try and artillery this row here to keep it back a little bit, I think. I think that's the way to go. And we're basically going to fire an artillery now and just get it going so it'll start reloading right away and we can reuse it as soon as possible. The goal, unfortunately, we missed. The goal was to clear the front row of these, and by failing that, that's not good for us. We're going to move these down here. We're going to fire... Where are they going? We're going to fire here. We're going to miss these two also, unfortunately. But the snipers maybe will clear them up before it spreads. Nope, got that wrong. Wow, we failed that mission bad. Here's the bird cannon. I'll show you what it looks like. It basically nukes an entire area, but we totally wiped out on that. Completely failed. We have to restart that one. Let's reuse the last position. I think we can get it to work, but let's move this up to here, and then we're going to try again just shooting down here. There's really no, if you want to set this here right away, there's really no, like, lives in this game. You pretty much either win or you lose each level. Like, I don't know, it's not really like a game over scenario. Let's fire this, like, here, I guess? I don't know. We need to get a kill on something here so we can get the bird cannon going. This needs to land. Okay. Come on, snipers. Our slow helicopter is killing us here. Yeah, we gotta try this again. The slow helicopter really hurts. So what do we want to do? Maybe we need to put... Maybe the sniper is in a bad position. Maybe the sniper should be... aimed up here, because it seems like they're mostly getting us from the top more than the side. Let's try it again. Let's go ahead and shoot our artillery off. Sniper's doing his job. Landmines are blowing up some stuff. There we go. The artillery did connect to that first part there, which is good. We need to put another one here. Try and cut this off if we can. We're going to move the helicopter down a little bit. Okay, that artillery is pretty good. We need to put this here and hope the helicopter gets back fast enough to call these guys out of the way. Okay, not so bad. We might make it this time. Possibly. Possibly. Maybe I should have repositioned this. We did get six this time. Let's fire just this here, and we're going to get as many kills as we can. It's good to get kills. You think you get more experience for certain things from time to time. Come on, helicopter. Hurry up. Hurry up. Sniper is doing some stuff, but not a lot. Probably should have aimed this artillery down here. We did get 60 out of 60, so we did finish this one at least. But where are these guys going? Helicopter's right here. Where are you guys going? Fail. Epic fail. Now you all die. Sad. We got 69 out of 60, so we did actually manage to clear it this time at least. We're going to increase sniper attack speed again down to 0.8. Still not a great one for us. We did outpace them slightly, but it wasn't beautiful by any means. It would have been nice to full clear that one, but it's okay. Yeah, so let's go ahead and do another... Ooh, okay, they're three short of getting these gas line ruptures, which... The gas line ruptures are actually kind of good for us in a sense. Faster Zed is a bonus for this one, which is kind of rough. Okay, nothing terrible here. What do we have? Infantry, barricades, and dynamites. Another not great one, but we'll go ahead and... push things here. Actually, let's... I want to kind of back out of this. Well, that's fine. I meant to upgrade something. That's okay. Alright. Barricades. Barricades are pretty useful, honestly. There's a lot of cool things you can do with them. It also barricades out our guys, which is bad. But now we set up this wall here. The only way in is through this street, and yeah, basically these three streets. So we can set our helicopter, you know, like here, roughly. Put our infantry basically here, I think is where we want it. To start clearing this out, and then we will start, we'll have to run them down here to clear out these guys in a little bit. So what we want to do is put dynamite here. Where'd that go? Here. Here. Here and here, maybe? Is that worth it? Here. And when these all fill in this spot, we're just gonna nuke that area. Okay, so we'll get rid of mover infantry. I think we're gonna do that first, but we can click this at any point to blow stuff up. Oh, I guess I should have put dynamite down here. That's fine. We're going to start moving our infantry back this way. And let's get ready to nuke everything. Okay, that pushed things back a little bit. Keep moving our infantry down here. Hopefully they'll take out these guys as much as possible. Uh-oh. That's bad for us. They're just so fast. This fast Zed is scary. Well, we just fired the bird cannon. We pretty much lost this one. F9 to restart. Okay, so how do we want to redo this? It seemed like we should have kept the infantry there longer, and maybe we should move this dynamite down here. Maybe this one here. Okay, let's try that again. Definitely, it seemed like where they came through was by this top spot. So if we leave the infantry here longer, I think that's the way to go. And get ready to blow up all this stuff as soon as we can. Okay, Is that outpaced? Oh my gosh. It just goes so fast sometimes when they start really moving. We're just gonna blow up all these, it doesn't really matter. I think we're super dead. Yep. Oh my gosh. We got wrecked. That did not work so well. Let's quit and save. Alright, not something we want. Okay, it worked. Continue campaign. Oh, we have to do the same mission. Okay. Huh. Let's give another try then. I was hoping we'd get like back out of this mission. I don't know if we concede what happens. Let's see what happens. Abandon city and return to the world map? Sure, do we lose? Oh. So basically if you concede, so now we have exploding gas lines, nothing happens. Like you just like the next month goes. That's kinda sucks. Level 4 Zed outbreak, so here's what happened. This is scary. They just dropped a 4 on us. We're getting destroyed in this one, by the way, guys. We're gonna buy the Catbird upgrade so it'll more rapidly be usable. Snipers, artillery, and dynamite. Sure, let's go for this. Ooh, I've never conceded a mission before. I've never tried to do that. I thought you didn't realize that would happen. So here's something interesting. So now we have these explosive gas lines. When this building is destroyed, they trigger massive explosions. That's actually bad and good. It's good. So here's like a bad thing. If we were to put this artillery nearby, the artillery would blow up when the gas line explodes. That's bad. So we're gonna put the artillery far away. The good thing, however, is that if we wait till a lot of Zed get here, we can just like nuke the crap out of this area, which is awesome. However, in this case, it looks like a lot of the Zed are all up here. So we're gonna set dynamite like this. And hopefully this will work out. We'll see what happens. I'm skeptical. Oh, wait, sniper team, right, of course. Like, man, we need something else here. A sniper team is great. Sniper team, we should set them up here. Have them take on this hallway here of bad guys. Okay, dynamite artillery, we're gonna set this off here. And get ready to launch the dynamite now. It's probably good. Artillery didn't do a lot for us, but it took out a few at least. That's a start. We're gonna shoot right here and hopefully catch quite a few of these bad guys. Where's the sniper? They've done their job already. Looks like they cleared that. Okay, we're gonna fire the catbird cannon over here and take out as much as we can. Hopefully it's quite a lot. And we need to reposition the snipers a little bit. We're gonna hopefully take out a few more up here with the artillery. Snipers are doing okay, although it looks like there's gonna be quite a few bad guys popping up here in a moment. So snipers need to clear that as best they can. Let's get them, snipers, finish them off. There's a few more there. Alright, reposition, get these last two and we win. Come on, let's do it. Come on, walk into it. There we go. Nice, nice. Wasn't sure we're actually gonna get that to work, but it did work out. And here's a nice thing, when you win a level 2 stage, you get a difficulty multiplier. So we actually got 510 points instead of 204, so that's huge, that's a big boost for us. And we're going to speed up our helicopter one more time, so now we're going to get a giant boost here. Gained satellite uplink to orbital elephant bird super cane. Approximately once a year, you'll be given control of this doomsday weapon. Huge boost, really big for us. So clearing out those higher level ones is really important. Now, we probably aren't going to get this next one, unfortunately. We're going to be close, but not quite. They're going to get a big bump here. It's going to be scary. Yeah, pretty scary. Alright, test the Elephant Bird Cannon. The Elephant Bird Cannon is amazing. You're going to see why in just a moment. This month, the Orbital Elephant Bird Doomsday Cannon is yours to control. Prepare to fire, to rain righteousness from the heavens above. Orbital Command suggests you tackle a heavy outbreak zone. Try to destroy all Zed before nightfall. Let's go to this most... the one on the edge. This seems good. What's a new research item? Upgrade clip size and shells per barrage. Okay, nope. Let's go to this edge one. Elephant bird cannon's really fun. It's almost like a mini game, I feel like. Planet killer array. Place the artillery crew, right? Let's place one here. Yeah, okay. Got it. Is that what we want? Where's the safest spot? That seems okay. Okay. Right click to fire artillery. You can see this is basically like a rapid fire, just nuking everything scenario. It's pretty awesome. We basically have like a really fast reload time. And we have the orbital bird cannon. We're gonna fire that up there. We're gonna shoot this down. We're basically just dropping fiery explosives on everything. Which is really fun, and it's an easy way to clear a tough level. There's almost no way to clear some of these level 4s without this type of a thing. But this makes it a lot easier, obviously, right? Much, much easier. Zed's dead. We get 100 points, and rescued 35 scientists as a bonus, which is nice. And now we have the Llama Bombs. Destroy multiple Zed territories in one fell swoop. Approximately once a year, you can use these. Okay, territory capture. That's good for us, too. We cleared up their 40-point territory. We gained a 20-point territory. We gained a 100-point bonus. And we upgraded this next level here, which is awesome. They're gonna get this, which is really scary, I think. They get, yeah, mutation. So, monolithic monstrosity sighted, beware of new Zed species. Yeah, here we go. Those things are big, and they're scary, and we're gonna have to fight them soon, so that's not as much fun. But now we have an extinction level bioweapon, so we're gonna use that. Llama Bombs. Get ready, drop some Llama Bombs. Instantly obliterate all Zed in multiple territories, select territories to cleanse. We have two payloads available. So basically, we can highlight over an area, and whatever we highlight over will get nuked by us. So we want to try and nuke multiple of these big things if we can, in most cases. And I think we can get three here. So let's do that. Cleared. And I don't think there's any way for us to get more than two here, right? We can't fit them both in the cursor. Close, but not quite. So we're gonna nuke these two. We could also nuke these types of things, but in general we want to try and capture these low ones, whereas getting rid of these big ones is a much bigger priority. There might be some scenario where you could kill like five, like, you know, if we get all of these in one or something, if they were all twos it might be worth it, but we're gonna nuke these guys. And we're done, so that helps a lot. So that's really good for us. Select her, so we have 40 points now to spend. What do we want to spend it on? So Mega Zeds are really hard to kill. Being able to kill them a little bit easier is really nice. Increases damage to 150 is really useful. And we have 25 more points to spend. Oh, I don't know. These are like, Llama Bomb only comes around once a year, so it's like every 12 missions, I think, so it's not very often. I think I'd rather unlock the bird cannon increase, probably good. So we have infantry, barricades, and dynamite. So that's not exactly a great one. And... dynamite. Okay, so maybe let's go for this level 1 here. Infantry, dynamite, barricades. Okay, let's just do that. I don't know if we're going to be able to clear a level 2 with infantry and dynamite. We can blockade these things real nicely, though. Put a blockade here. Put a blockade here. And let's throw a third one on here. And set our infantry to clear out this one, and we're just gonna set up like a bunch of dynamite here to hopefully wipe that out, and then put our helicopter here, and that should pretty much take care of it. I think we should have a pretty easy time on this mission. Infantry should be able to handle one wave by themselves. Oh wait, I totally forgot. They have those big scary guys now, which is really, really bad. Yeah, whoops. My bad. I totally forgot about those big guys. They make things a lot more complicated. Considerably more complicated. We're gonna have to redo this mission for sure. Epic fail. Okay. So, the way we need to do this... we're gonna restart the mission. So we just need to set up the dynamite to kill those big guys from the start. and then we'll be fine. However, we want to back up our infantry so they don't get caught in that explosion. And that should pretty much take care of it. You wait for the big guys to come out, as long as you can, and then you blow them all up with the dynamite. Those did not die, however. I thought that would have killed them. A little disappointed, to be honest. I hope the infantry can kill them, but I don't think they can. You pretty much have to blow those things up to have any chance. Okay. Can we restart the mission? Let's restart the mission. So it's almost a puzzle game in a sense, right? Like, it's a real-time strategy, sort of. Because you do make some on-the-fly decisions, but it's a lot of... So I want to stack our dynamite a little more. To try and get them to all land at the same time. To kill, you know, have all the big guys stand in the same pile of dynamite. There we go. It took like 2 hits of the dynamite to actually clear it off, but we got it. And that's with, you might remember I mentioned that we took the bonus to explosive damage to those big giant ones. That's what those guys were. It still took like 2s of the dynamite to clear it, so that was pretty important to have that bonus, I think. Let's get the infantry up here to clear out these last couple, and then we're all good. Come on, infantry, speed up, speed up. We could also nuke things, but we don't need to do that. Come on, get them. I think the zombies are running away from our infantry. There we go, got them. The only way to lose the infantry, by the way, is having them blow up, pretty much. So, as long as you don't have them blow up from like a dynamite or explosive or gas pipe leak, then you're all good. Okay. Well, I think we will call it here. We're only about halfway through, and it does speed up as you go farther along in the game, but it does take a while to actually finish through an entire campaign on this 6,000 point mode. But that's pretty much Atom Zombie Smasher, and I really like this game. I think it is super fun. It's not... You can make it very difficult. If you want to make it very difficult, you easily can. If you want to not make it difficult, you can do that too. You can go to a new campaign, you can go a short campaign, you can start off fully stocked, so you get all the weapons to begin. You can carry an extra merc right away, which is nice, because like you saw, we had like 3 at a time, you can carry 4 with this. You can spend scientists to purchase llama bombs. What else can you do? Yeah, this is a nice one, combatant. It always will include 1 offensive unit, so you don't get like barricades and bait and crap like that. Sometimes you'll literally get ones like barricades, bait, and maybe like, I don't know what another one is, like landmines, which are fine, but you only get like 1 use out of those, so you really have very limited, it's very difficult. Triplets is fun, because you can carry more than 1 of the same mercenary types. If you want 3 infantry, you can. Choose lets you choose what you want instead of making it random. Hardcore is much harder, obviously. Casual is much easier. Permadeath, you can't restart the missions. Spawn Zed in the middle of cities is kind of cool, and they can invade any territory. So, and Chris Kringle's on the rampage. I have no idea what this actually does. I have no clue what that one is. I've never used that one before. But there's lots of cool things you can do to customize the game. You can even set a custom game if you don't want 2,000, 6,000, 20,000 points. You can do 5 points or 10,000 points or something. So it's really fun. It allows a lot of replayability because of these customizations. There's not much else to it. There's some mods and extras, but I've never gone into any of these things. I don't exactly know what all's there. And this is my old save file got wiped. I like deleted it on accident when I deleted this from Steam at some point. So I no longer have all my save files, unfortunately. But you can see there's lots of updates they did over time. The game first launched, let's see, the pre-release build was in early 2011, and they were updating it as late as, lots of questions, as late as the end of 2011. So they did about a year of support on the game, which is really nice. The gameplay added Kringle the Jammer minigame, so kind of cool. But yeah, so that's pretty much it for the day. I hope you guys had fun. Hope you guys enjoyed watching it. I think it's a pretty fun game overall. I really like it, and I recommend it for you guys. If you have never played before, it's one of my favorite games. Very cool. But that's all for today, so thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.